Alright guys, so this is usually how I do some rib prepping. So this flap right here, I always try to cut most of that off. It just kinda makes it neater. I mean, yeah, I'm not entering any competitions or anything crazy like that, but I just kinda like it off. And then a lot of times I'll put it up on the top rack while I'm smoking, and kind of makes it good for like little taster things, like after you know, when I always take the membrane off. There's some people that won't do this. I always do because I don't know. I just think it, to me, it gets the flavor down into the meat when you take the membrane off. It's just me. I don't know. There's actually quite a few people that do it. I take a lot of tips from, there's some barbecue things that I watch online. Barbecue Pit Masters, there's, you know, a lot of stuff like that that I like to watch. This is not coming up easy. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't, but, you know, you get the gist. See, that's how they're supposed to come off, really. Anyway, we'll do that part later. Anyway, on to the meat. This thing's still kind of frozen, so bear with me. That's how you want it right there. If you can get the membrane to come off in one strip, then you are styling, man. Look at that. That is what I am talking about. Okay. And it didn't all really come off because it cut in strips, it appears to be, but that is okay too. You can throw a little bit on there too. Why not? Alright, so, I'm going to throw all that into a bag for the next step. Alright guys, I'm going to get some wood chips together. Sarah's being very vocal. Alright, now with pork, I like to use a lot of fruit wood, so I do a little bit of apple. Apple gives that sweet taste, of course, and then I like to use maple in addition to, I do three woods in my smoker, so a little bit of maple. Yeah, I get this stuff at Bass Pro Shops. Maple wood chips, you can get it at a lot of different places, a lot of different barbecue places have it. And that gives it a really sweet taste than the maple does. You kind of notice it. I mean, you know, some people say they can't taste the difference, but I don't know. I kind of can, I think. Anyway, and then, last but not least, cherry. That cherry has like a really, it's like a thick smoke. It's kind of a stronger smoke. So I always add that into my smoke, so get those three all mixed in, all the different layers of sweetness, kind of, you know, if you were downwind of this stuff, you would, like, be attracted real quick. Believe me, I'm sure the neighbors are going to be killing it right about now, so. Yes, Sarah, we're going to go out to the smoker. Just a second there, kiddo. Alright, next step, to the smoker. Alright guys, I was waiting for heat to come up and it didn't come up as much as we'd like it to, so we put a little bit of charcoal in the main body, so we're going to see how that works out, but in the meantime, hey, that bad boy's on there, so got a little bit of the little small pieces of trimmings up on top there, so we're going to see how those turn out too. Anyway, we're going to let this thing go for about an hour and a half and we're going to wrap it. Alright guys, this is the part where we do a little bit of wrapping. But before we wrap, we gotta do some seasoning. So, I'm gonna do a little bit of brown sugar. That always works really well with pork. Brown sugar is also like the base of a lot of the rubs as well on pork, or at least the ones that I use. Then we're gonna do a little bit of butter. Real butter, of course. We don't mess with that margarine stuff. Not in this kitchen. We don't play fake. Do a little bit of that, a little bit of real butter cubed, then we're going to move on to do some honey action. Yeah, buddy. Got to get the layers of sweet going on here, man. Just going to be doing a little bit of drizzling action. These are the beauties that just came off the grill. Just for a moment while we wrap them though. And we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Gonna be doing a little bit of this. It all melts in. Last but not least, yep, you guys get the honey. Get layers in there, man. Layers of sweet. Yeah. Alright. This is when we wrap it back up and back it goes on the grill. This is where you want to put a little bit more heat in your main body too, because you're going to want to escalate this a little bit. A lot of people say you can probably just leave it on 225, but I don't know. I like to kick it up a notch. A little bit more coverage there. A little bit. All right, man, and we're back on the grill. All right, and that's the final outcome. That's what happens after you pull them out and cut them up. You already missed that part, but anyway, bon appetit, y'all.